Hello everyone, greetings of the day. My name is Dr. Pargat Singh Garcha, Principal GHG Khalsa College of Education, Gurusar Sudhar, Ludhiana, Punjab, India. Sat Shri Akal. Today, I am going to present my presentation on MOOC on Cooperative Learning Pedagogy. This is a 4-week course. Before going into the details of my presentation, I would like to share the starting point of my journey. This beautiful journey started 2 years back when I attended one workshop at SNDT University, Mumbai, India, where I came to know about the concept of open education for a better world. Last year, I applied for this project and luckily I got a chance to work with seasoned personalities on this course. So now I am going to start my presentation on MOOC on Cooperative Learning Pedagogy. It is developed under online mentoring program. My course was related with SDG goals, which is related to ensure inclusive and quality education for all and promote lifelong learning. This is an overview of the presentation. In this presentation, I will discuss about the project, the introduction, the project results, summary, list of already existing OER, how we fared, how the program was developed, lesson learned, user feedback, and future plan and suggestions. Starting from the first one about the project. The title of the project or my course is Cooperative Learning Pedagogy. Introductory level course, it was developed in English language. The duration of the course was 4 weeks. The target group of people on this course were pre-service and in-service teachers, teacher educators, curriculum planners, and students. The platform we used for this course was MOOCIT platform. This course is available on the link given below the screen. This course was not possible without the able guidance of my mentor. Sir has guided me on each and every step, and I am also thankful to my Asia Hub coordinators. As far as the motivation for this project is concerned, why I chosen this topic, there are some reasons. The first reason is cooperative learning is close to my heart. The next one was I always believe that teacher needs to be facilitator of children's learning. The next is cooperative learning strategies provide structure for students' interaction in an organized way and develop higher order thinking skills. It is one of the most widely investigated educational approaches. So these were the main reason behind selecting this topic for my massive open online course on cooperative learning pedagogy. This idea of developing MOOC on cooperative learning pedagogy got proper shape when I framed the learning objective of this course. The course was divided into 4 modules and module wise objectives are framed. This is the content which we develop during the course as per our objectives. Along with this content, in each module, one quiz was given, and in 4 modules, one assignment was designed to involve the participant in a learning process. Each module-wise learning objectives were framed. As per the objectives, content of the course was developed, video lectures, concept map, PDF files were created under CC by SC license. As this year project was focusing upon use of existing OER, so by following the guidelines, some of the OERs were identified, analyzed, and included in the course. Module wise quizzes and assignments were developed. Existing MOOC platform were seen, and after detailed discussions with the mentor, MOOCIT platform was finalized. The course was put on online platform MOOCIT. Course brochure along with introductory video was shared on various social media platforms. And through this efforts, we succeeded to get attention of around 5,000 participants of this course. The main focus of the implementation was active and self-paced learning during the 4 weeks, continuous support to students through the Hangout, discussion forums, emails, Telegram, mobile phone. We try our best to provide student support throughout the course 24/7. Continuous assessment and feedback was made. There was provision for students to track their progress. This is the list of already existing OER which were used in present course. This is very important slide, and this is the real result or product of our hard work of few months. The figures clearly shows that we were able to get attention of 4,861 students who registered with us on MOOCET platform, and out of these, 3,147 were active students throughout the course, which was encouraging figure. We conducted a pre-course survey where we came to know that many of the participants have no experience of any course on MOOC, and you can see the 38,691 comments posted by the participant and 6,419 forums created by them, which shows the active participation of the students or the participant in this course. These figures are really encouraging and motivating. This is the slide showing the daily discussion forum activities. You can see that around 2,1500 participants were continuously involving in daily discussion forum activities. Based on the modular approach, we developed 4 modules. Creative Commons license video lessons were developed and uploaded on YouTube. Some of the available open educational resources were identified and analyzed. CC BY SA license content in the form of concept map and PDF files were prepared. Quizzes, assignments, rubrics were developed in each module for continuous assessment of students' progress. Discussion forums, hangouts, emails, phone calls, Telegram group were used to assist learners. What are the lessons we learned from this project? We learned that there is scope for developing more quality MOOCs in teacher training areas. The course participants or learners were really interested to learn innovative methods like cooperative learning strategies through quality, massive open online courses. So there is a very good scope to develop more courses. For assessment of large number of participants, there is need of e-tutors or peer assessment feature in MOOC platform. As we were dealing with more than 4,000 registered users, so we learned a lesson that when you are providing course to more than 3,000, 4,000 participants, the course platform must have the facility of peer assessment, need of continuous support through various modes, and hand-holding for first-time participant in MOOCs. We observed that due to the corona pandemic, there was too much pressure on network connectivity, and due to some weather conditions in some parts of India, many participants were in trouble. So for those participants, the continuous support was very important to make them active learner in the course. We tried our best and we got a good result that many of the participants remain active throughout the course. We also learned a lesson that before implementing the course, we need one demonstration video regarding the selected MOOC platform so that all the participants will be very familiar to use the particular platform. These were the lessons we learned from our course. This is very important slide, the user feedback. This is the real output in our hands. We conducted post-course survey. Till date, more than 1,774 participants have answered the questions on post-course survey. And few of the examples are shown on that slide. One question was, did you find this course helpful? 99.9% participant said yes. MOOCAT platform shows that the feedback given by the participant is really encouraging and motivating us to work more in this field and develop more courses. Our first future plan is take this project further and relaunching the course again, as audience has shown lot of interest and positive feedback. We are also thinking that using another platform where peer evaluation can be used to evaluate work of large number of participants. Then we are also thinking on translating the course into other languages. We are also exploring other methods of cooperative learning and development of MOOC on those methods or strategies. We are also planning to prepare ebook on cooperative learning lesson plans. I would also like to make one humble submission before the Open Education for a Better World team to develop one MOOC platform where all the project develop under the guidance of Open Education for a Better World online mentoring program can be launched at one place. Another one suggestion to the team is we can develop a community of all the developers and mentors to share best practices. We can learn from each other. Next comes the thanks. First of all, I would like to thank my respected mentor, Dr. R.C. Sharma ji, who was the main driving force behind this project. Sir has given direction on each small step, given shape to my raw ideas. Thank you very much, sir, from core of my heart. My sincere gratitude to my Asia Hub coordinators, Dr. Vasudha Kamath ji and Dr. Jayashri Shinde ji and Dr. Anja ji for continuous guidance and support through the emails. We were in touch with the Open Education for Better World team. Thanks in abundance goes to the Open Education for Better World organization who provided this wonderful opportunity to meet above mentioned seasoned personalities in my life. Last but not the least, I would also like to thank all the participants of my course who registered with us, who were active during 28 days. We are really thankful to each and every one related with our course. Thank you. Thank you very much.